welcome to MBS Show Reviews and Discussion Podcast. I am your host, Norman Sanzo. Joining me today is Silver-Quill.
I've always been considered a washout, mostly because I overclean my clothes.
Alrighty then. Also joining us is Sapphire Heart Song.
I truly am a washout. Hi, no one knows me.
Aww.
But you have more subs than me.
Yeah, well, I get less views than you. So what does that tell you?
I have no idea. But anywho, also joining us today is Totera.
I did something that makes me a washout. You see, someone tried catching me and I got rid of them.
Yay!
All I did was just pick them up and throw them away.
Alrighty then. So anywho, in today's episode review, we are going to review Season 8, Episode 20, The Washouts. In this episode, Scootaloo becomes enamored with the Washouts, a touring group of stunt ponies, and Rainbow Dash is concerned for her safety and worried that Scootaloo's day as her number one fan are over. So before we head into the reviews, let's go for first impressions. Silver, my friend, what do you think of said episode?
I enjoyed this one. It's nice to see Lightning Dust again. I will admit, part of me was hoping she'd join Starlight's clique of outcasts. Because you have Trixie, the Unicorn, Maud, the Earth Pony, Lightning Dust that would be a great addition. And you could have like the friend that who doesn't get along with another friend. Although I will say that Wonderbolts Academy made me very sympathetic towards Lightning Dust because I feel like she got the raw deal. This one's like, okay, yeah, now they're trying to make her borderline villain.
All right. I think, well, you know, I'm going to hold my tongue for a bit. So anyway, Sabi, what do you think of said episode?
Well, I like that Apple Bloom had to learn how to not be a bratty teenager. Well,
Apple Bloom?
Not Apple Bloom, Scootaloo, sorry, it's been a while.
you just triggered the sweetie bot.
I did?
I heard shoot.
I heard something different.
Yeah, I heard something else.
I didn't hear anything.
I can't say it. I'm not getting sweetie botted for you.
You could.
Not on this episode, my friends. But anywho, editing side-wise, what do you think?
I like how Scootaloo actually had to learn a lesson about, you know, sort of like it's a two-way street. It's like a parent who's dealing with a bratty teenager. Like, the teenager wants to set on their own path, but the parent just wants them to, you know, it's been a while. I don't have my head thought cleared, and I'm just gonna shut up.
So what you're saying is Scootaloo is basically a Disney princess.
Yep.
Oh, really now? So, Tara, what do you mean by that?
Well, I mean, Safi does bring up a good point about
I want more!
I mean, she does bring up a good point, but, you know, it's like in life, when you're young, you want things to be done your way, and then after once you get it, be like, oh, this isn't exactly what I imagined. It also kind of brings back something on Season 1, I believe. But it was also a good episode. It was good to see Lightning Dust again. And I kind of agree with Silva on what he said, because back in Wonderbolts Academy, I felt bad for Lightning Dust too and wondering, oh, well, what is she going to do now that she's not going to be a Wonderbolt? And now we see her kind of like as a villain.
All right. And as for me, this episode was a lot of fun. I can see some people disliking this episode for reasons. And yeah, I can understand why. But I do like seeing how the quote-unquote trend of the week is grabbing everyone and everyone's like enamored by them. Like, ooh, even Princess Twilight went to go to get her poster signed and whatnot. So, yeah, that's a lot of fun to see. But other than that, like the whole morale of the story and so on, I think we'll hold that off till we get to the, whatchamacallit, episode review itself. So anyway, if you guys have not watched this episode, pause here and go watch it. Welcome back. So I hope you guys enjoyed the episode. Now time to hear what we think in depth. So we start off with the prologue, where Scootaloo is holding a club meeting for the Rainbow Dash fan club. And the thing with this fan club meeting is it's kind of quick. Like, everybody gather around after their day jobs and whatnot, and they got all chased out. Like, what? That's not good. So after everybody got chased out, Scootaloo kind of rips all the poster out and decided to do a new fan club dedicated to the Washouts. And by this time, like, while I'm describing this, Rainbow Dash has been spying on Scootaloo. Concerns.
It's not weird or anything.
I know.
It's not creepy.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, who wouldn't like to spy on their own fan club, right?
I know.
Hell, I've got surveillance drones on all three of you right now.
What?
Oh. Pay no attention. They're just hovering outside your house.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I hope you enjoy...
You don't even know where I live.
Technically, he does.
Well, he doesn't know where I live.
Don't I?
No, I don't believe you do, sir.
Ooh, belief, because belief will instantly make it true.
So true.
But, well, I don't believe it.
Unless you have the drones over at my Silver-Quill clubhouse. Which I do believe. I did something on DeviantArt in 2015.
Well, now we're just droning on.
Yes, indeed. But anywho, let's move on. So, Rainbow Dash busts in and kind of confronts Scootaloo about her new interests. And yeah, she got caught. And she likes this new team called the Washouts. They're a stunt flying troop, blah, 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 and so on. They're like the Wonderbolts, but much better and much more extreme.
It's become a 90s commercial.
Indeed.
God, Lord, help us all.
Actually, now you look at their costumes, and yeah, there's a strange Mountain Dew tint to it all.
But anywho, I'm just going to wrap this part up because, yeah, Scootaloo likes the Washouts while Rainbow Dash says who the hey are they. And, yeah, Rainbow Dash is concerned because she's losing a number one fan. So she goes to the girls and tells them about it. And, yeah, Applejack has concerns that if Apple Bloom likes bananas instead of apples, she'll kind of do an ass whooping and stuff. That's not good.
So Applejack's racist, got it.
No.
It's been proven prevalent that she is racist towards other fruits that aren't apples.
But that's producist.
Well, let's not forget that she did eat strawberries on pancakes now.
And yet she yelled at someone for liking strawberries.
Well, liking them more than apples.
Exactly.
But yes, she ate strawberries. And I'm so proud of her. Such character growth.
They grew up so fast.
Although I can imagine her going through a teenage Scootaloo's dresser and finding in a plastic bag at the bottom banana slices.
Silver!
Oh no, the horror, the horror. But anywho, I'm going to try and move along. So the other girl says, like, yeah, the Washouts are kind of cool and whatnot, and their advertising seems extreme. And yeah, let's go check them out, you know, because knowing thy enemy makes us more ready for their defeat and something like that. Is that how he says? Hey, no?
Know thy enemy. That's really all you got
to
say.
Yeah. But anywho, they go to their show, and Rainbow Dash is just pointing things out that are kind of derpy. Like, oh, they're just copying the Wonderbolts because we have bleachers. They have bleachers. We have bleachers too. Look, they have cotton candy and they have popcorn. Like, oh my god. And the next thing you're going to say, EA has selling stuff for money and whatnot. Oh no.
Hey, as long as she doesn't use the phrase, we're the real OG.
At least they're not selling loot boxes.
Oh, I'm guessing she's going to say that too. Oh, they want to sell loot boxes too. And look at them. They're copying us.
They tackled loot boxes in season 7 with that box that Sunburst found. Oh. Remember, kids, loot boxes can save the world. Buy them all.
No.
Well, that depends. Is that a legendary box or a common box?
It's unknown until you open it.
That's right. All the legendaries can have diddly squat.
Oh, my God. Are you talking about... Oh, is that game Anthem?
Oh, I'm still on Overwatch. I don't know about the rest of you.
I am on Overwatch, but Anthem has a terrible rap. Like, goodbye, BioWare.
Really?
Yep. Now, that is another conversation for another day, my friends. But anywho, let's start the show. The announcer has a loud booming voice, announced that the Washout comes, Washout are here. They come in, they perform, and they are hardcore. Like, they are really good. They run through obstacle course, they do some stuff. And yeah, their stunt show is amazing and nail-biting, yes.
But ponies don't have nails.
Then what are they chewing on?
Their own skin!
No. But
actually, I believe a horse's hoof is indeed made from the same material that you find in your hair or your fingernails.
Or
is it the same? To Google.
So yeah, while Silver researches on horse hooves, I'm gonna carry on. So Scootaloo here is kind of shy meeting up with the Washouts because they're awesome and I'm scared of them. And Rainbow Dash is like, kid, you know me, I'm awesome, they're awesome, it's gonna mix well. So she introduces herself and kind of boasts that she's a Wonderbolt. And the rest of them laugh it off because they were Wonderbolts too but got kicked out. And most of the time they got kicked out for disciplinary reasons. So yeah, we're gonna see a pattern here where it's not good. So anywho, they introduce them to, who was her name again? Dang it.
The Australian one?
Yeah. What was her name again?
The one that winked at a lady in the crowd and said, all the shippers are shipping.
Yeah. Rolling Thunder. So we got Rolling Thunder. She introduces herself and she has an Australian accent. That's really cool. Junkrat's going to be proud. And also we got Short Fuse.
He definitely looks a lot like someone else we know, right, Silver?
Usually when he's really mad, yeah.
Especially when you throw off those puns, right?
Including when I applaud his puns. you can hear the shame. Yeah, see where he's shouting at Rainbow Dash? I definitely see a resemblance. Maybe if there was more of a vein bulge in his neck.
Oh, God. Oh, my goodness. Why? Oh, boys. But
hey, he may pay me, but I still get to make fun of him.
Darn straight.
All right, yeah. So, anywho, they all explained that their ex-Wonderbolts got kicked out. And Rainbow Dash asks, then who's the leader? And comes in, awesomely, it's Lightning Dust. And they say their name, like Lightning Dust, Rainbow Dash, Scootaloo,
SpongeBob,
and Steven.
You know what's funny? This episode aired earlier, and I believe it was Swedish. And Scootaloo sounded absolutely adorable in that dub.
Really, you know?
Scootaloo. she's so sweet. It's like, oh my gosh. Oh, I wish I spoke this adorable language.
That'll be something for you to pick up later on in life.
I don't know if I can.
Actually, I have a friend who's Swedish.
Oh, that's cool.
The most I could do with Swedish is a non-offensive stereotype. Jeeberskor, pedikadee, pedikadur. Jeeberski, berski, ki, bork, bork, bork.
I couldn't resist. I had to join in.
Mother Celestia, please help us all.
Ungish for the pukey man.
Oh my goodness. So, anywho. Scootaloo is surprised that Rainbow Dash and Lightning Dust has history, and Lightning Dust says here that she's happy that she got kicked out because she can start the Washouts and she's raking in a lot of cash and doing the things she loves. Ain't that awesome?
Well, sorta.
We're treading old ground almost. They start off, Rainbow's sort of enamored with Lightning Dust's skill. And they start to have this mutual respect. And then it breaks apart. We're kind of following the same beats as Wonderbolt Academy in a new setting.
True. But hey, it's one of those things where if it works, right? because you have the two most awesome slayer in the group. They respect one another, but they hate each other's guts and whatnot. And yeah, this time around, like Lightning Dust says, oh, water under bridge. I'm rich now. I'm doing the thing I like, so yay, much awesomeness. And yeah, now here comes the part where Scootaloo is being influenced and he wants to be a washout. And the things that the washout are doing is really, really dangerous. Like the stunts they're doing, let's just say that they're almost like YouTubers where they're doing prank videos. It's just a prank, bro.
Yeah, I lit you on fire. Just a prank, brah.
Yep. So, anywho, Rainbow Dash seeing red lights, like signal lights, like, oh, this is bad, decides to bring Scootaloo to the Wonderbolts Academy and show her the awesomeness of the Wonderbolts and how safe they are. And how do I even put this? Being too safe is boring?
It's the idea, I guess, of it's structured, it's coordinated, it's not necessarily flashy. And a lot of people mistake flash for substance.
True. But I don't know. I mean, I'm thinking of something in real life where when you see stunts being done, like, how do I put this? Like, when you see the air show, all those practice that they do is pretty awesome. And then when you see the roller derby or the NASCAR races, those aren't practice or scripted. Those are just drivers who have years of experience running around the track or driving around the track, turning left.
They're making a left turn!
And they're making another left turn! Oh, and what's this now? He's gonna do another left turn!
But suddenly, there's that one idiot who did it right.
Derek Zoolander has crashed! I just get turned left!
So, yeah, everybody here, or everybody really likes to see a train wreck. But those train wrecks are not fun.
Well, not for the drivers.
True.
No.
True. But carrying on to my point, Rainbow Dash talks to Spitfire and telling her all the dangers that could happen if you don't practice your tricks and whatnot. And, oh wow, like, her line is just so awesome.
It's so memorable, too.
Yep. And you know what?
You'll be in a full body pony cast, drinking through a straw. That sounds like something my dad would say.
Wow. Yep.
I think more than a few people were fondly remembering Chris Farley.
But why do I hear No Viking? I hear No Viking in this role, and her reprising her role as what was that?
Anime? Vinyl.
No, not Vinyl. The other anime she did, like the abridged series, Black Lagoon.
Oh, as Revy?
Yeah.
Hmm. Interesting.
I'm just hearing that, so it's like, oh my god, that's so much cool. That's so much fun. But anywho, yeah. Moving on. Memorable scene. Check it out if you haven't. Like, this is fun. This is fun. Like, she's just expressing herself really well. So in the end, Scootaloo is not really affected by the scare tactic. Like, she's more annoyed than anything. And while Rainbow Dash just says to her, you know what, let's get all those stupid washout stuff and let's dump them in a ravine and burn them, whatever it is. And while she's doing this, Scootaloo's gone. She try and finds her and bumps into Twilight, who has a sign poster of the washouts. Oh no, she's a fan too.
She's joined the dark side, I think.
Yeah. But
no, she's joined the Mountain Dew side.
Oh no.
It's Princess Twilight Extreme!
Well, princesses do get discounts.
True, they are royalty after all.
Yep. But anywho, Twilight says, aren't you overreacting about this? I mean, Scootaloo can like what she likes. I mean, are you afraid that she's not going to be your number one fan anymore? And well, Rainbow Dash kind of admitted it, kind of, yeah. But anywho, so Rainbow Dash follows her pride and goes to Lightning Dust and asks, have you seen where Scootaloo is? And she says, Oh, have I? Well, take a look at our newest member. And it's Scootaloo. Oh no, Scootaloo has joined the dark side. Now she's going to be drinking Mountain Dew and eating Doritos. Oh no.
Honestly, now I'm just kind of picturing her lying back as the Washouts helmet descends upon her and clamps into place. Extreme.
Yeah. So Rainbow Dash chews her out, and Scootaloo just says, "I will never be a Wonderbolt because I can't fly." Is that what you want to hear? And that kind of slaps Rainbow Dash in the face. Goodness me.
Well, I think it's a very telling line. Just because I look up to you doesn't mean I want to be you. Which is a very healthy attitude. She still looks up to Rainbow Dash.
True, true. And, well, with that, they go their separate ways. Rainbow Dash feeling a bit crummy and kind of goes off to think about stuff. So, anywho, on the next day, I hope they start the Washouts. They start a new show, they start new stuff, and they introduce their newest member called Half Pint. And Why?
Carry on.
All right. So, anywho, so Half Pint here has to do this stunt. It's a really, really old stunt. Anybody remember? Well, there's a few awesome stunt artists over there. What was his name? Evil Knievel, Super Dave. Yay. Remember Super Dave?
I remember his Saturday morning cartoon.
Johnny Knoxville.
Yeah. But yeah,
I did love Super Dave.
Yeah, I love the cartoon, and the live action scenes were fun.
I'm guessing this is an old cartoon or something like that.
Yep.
You shut up with your face now.
I don't know all these old things, okay? I'm not that old.
Oh, I see how it is. I see how it is with you people.
Well, now you just insulted him. Congrats.
Hey, if I'm going to be a Pokemon slave to him, I'm going to fight fire with fire.
But you're a grass type.
I thought I was the...
That's it. We're breaking out the blue Pokeballs again.
So, anywho, let me continue this and you can fight the Poke Battles. So, once they arrive at the stunt location, Scooter is having second thoughts on the act, because what's going on here is that Scootaloo has to ride her scooter down the ramp with a very dangerous looking rocket pack behind her, accelerating her to Mach speed. And this is not tested. And with that, Lightning Dust straps her onto the scooter and push the ignition button. And oh no! We're going to have a death in Equestria.
This is where Lightning Dust becomes a villain, because she's endangering a foal. There's no spin doctor that. You're the bad guy now. All you need is a skull on your uniform. Are we the bad guys?
But here's the thing. Like, in all honesty, it's one of those situations where you sign up for this, you know what you're getting yourself into. Okay, there's the whole release form from the parents and whatnot that needs to be signed, but...
Aha! Scootaloo doesn't have parents.
Yeah, not gonna say anything
about
that.
She has a couple
one.
Of aunts, though.
Yeah. And her parents are still around, but you know what? Not gonna talk about that one for now. So anyway...
Oh no, we're gonna play up the sympathy card. Norman, what makes you think anyone has signed a permission slip?
No.
Scootaloo just disappears and does everything behind ponies' backs.
Yeah, I'm saying that. I mean, in terms of what you would call this logicness and whatnot, like, yes, this is cartoons. In all honesty, for Scootaloo to do this, she needs a waiver from parents and whatnot and a contract and stuff. And yeah, let's just say this is just a cartoon for reasons.
Let's say it's a cartoon for reasons when you put a child on a rocket. I'm going to have a very strongly worded letter for these
people. Yeah, not really a good message to put towards kids.
Yeah, but...
Dear Lightning Dust, you biznatch, what were you doing?
Yeah,
You best step off, sister, for shizzle.
So, anywho, while Scootaloo is in a panic and praying to her savior or maker that she doesn't die, Rainbow Dash swoops in and kind of saves Scootaloo. And she says that, yeah, I should respect what you want and want to do, but that doesn't mean I can't swoop in and save the day. So, yays. So, they land safely, and Lightning Dust says, like, if I knew you were going to bail on the stunt, I should have done it myself. And Rainbow Dash says, you might want to watch out. That rope is going, oh, bye-bye, Lightning Dust. And yeah, Lightning Dust got carried away with the rocket and is blasting off again.
Rivals for life. Of course, they just lost a fortune in their set.
Oh, yeah. Well,
that's true.
You're not getting those ramps back. In fact, Rainbow Dash be like, these belong to the Wonderbolts now. Yeah, ours.
They're mine.
Dibs.
They just have to change the color and get rid of the Mountain Dew stuff.
Yeah, change sponsors and whatnot. Yeah, it works. So Rainbow Dash says, like, Squirt, you're awesome and whatnot, and you don't really have to prove yourself like this. And also, why don't you spy on your club, the Scootaloo fan club? Yay! And the Scootaloo fan club here is just awesome because we get to see their club members. And no, most notable club members are Rainbow Dash's parents.
I'm just wondering, where did they get that hat printed that looks like a giant version of Scootaloo's head? Because, you know, the printer's looking down at this and looking at the people and be like, y'all got issues.
Yep.
Lots of issues.
True that, true that. But what I'm most concerned is Snip and Snails. Like, why are they there?
Well, especially Snips, who's looking a little too eager.
But anywho,
the waifu wars.
But anywho, Scootaloo says, yeah, spying on your own club is not creepy. It's most exhilarating. Isn't that right, Silver?
Yes. Yes. And now go forth, my drone army.
But anywho, with that, episode ends. So let's hit...
I love that I've been greeted by both the Empire marching theme and the flying monkeys. They both work.
They both work so well.
Boy, so anywho, let's go into final thoughts. Silver, what do you think?
Well, this was, in my eyes, a really fun episode just to welcome back Lightning Dust, even for just one episode. Like I say, it would have been interesting to have a story where you make friends with someone who just doesn't get along with one of your other friends. Interesting thing to explore, but that's more my own fan fiction headcanon territory. This was pretty good for Scootaloo because it showed a lot of growth on her part. Remember how hero worshipy she was of Rainbow Dash at the start? Rainbow could do no wrong. Now here's an older, cutie marked Scootaloo who's just doing things that she enjoys. She's branching out. She's becoming a more diverse person, pony, what have you. So that scene where she admits that she'll never be able to fly. One, never say never, but at the same time, she's not waiting for that to happen to celebrate herself, and I applaud that. Honestly, I wouldn't mind if one day Scootaloo became the boss of the Washouts and just revised it to be a more responsible group. If, like, they disbanded and she reorganized them, that'd be something.
True, or she could just start off the esports team. No, not esports, like the extreme sports, like the skateboards and whatnot. She could be doing the Tony Hawk thing. Yay.
By the way, I did a search, and human fingernails are made out of keratin, the same material found in horse hooves.
I knew it. I was right. Yay.
Awesome.
It's a good day.
But anywho, is that all, Silva?
I think they'll do it.
All right, then. And what about you, Seppi?
Pretty much the same opinion as I've given throughout. It's nothing but a Disney princess story.
Really, no.
A child versus their parent. Like, you can't tell me what to do. I know what's best for me. Oh, crap, I don't know. Oh no, I am doomed. Save me.
Alright, then.
Was that a Sweetie Bot moment back there?
I said crap.
Yeah, do we count that?
I don't know. Sweetie Bot's kind of okay with that.
Because I just feel like Safi, she's danced the line this review.
Yeah, like Archer.
Potty mouth. What, Pam?
Yeah. But anywho, Tara, what about you?
Well, I really enjoyed this episode. The comedy was really great, especially, I mean, we could all agree that the one with Spitfire is a very memorable scene.
Oh, yeah.
And, like, while Silver did bring up a good point about how Lightning Dust, they could have, like, done a thing where, you know, it's okay to have someone else as a friend, or, like, the way, it could also be less than, like, hey, you know, they could also, it's fine to also look up to other people, and it can't just be one person. But then Lightning Dust had to be all evil, and it's like, okay, I'm going back to Rainbow Dash again.
And as for me, this episode was a lot of fun to watch, and yeah, like Tara said, the Spitfire scene was so much fun. Like, I think after this, I'm just gonna go watch it again, because it's just so much fun. But anywho, besides that, Scootaloo has grown a lot throughout this whole 8 seasons, and getting to see her grow out of her hero worship and tries to be her own pony, that's kind of cool. And at least she likes doing other things, like liking another sports crew, so yay.
Though, isn't it funny, Scootaloo had to go like 3 seasons before she actually got an episode
three
to herself
seasons. Was it like, is this the...
Yeah.
Oh, okay. What was the previous one? The last one?
Well, okay. The last one I remember was when they went to Mount Eris. But let's see here. The episode where it was the first time Scootaloo really was a central character, was about her, was back in season 3, Sleepless in Ponyville.
Oh, that's been a while.
That was her first episode. Sweetie Belle and Apple Bloom both got a little bit more focus earlier on. So it's just like, why is she being neglected? And yet she may have shown some of the most growth.
I do remember that one now, like Sleepless in Ponyville, was it?
Yes.
Yeah. So that one was kind of not bad. Like, I do remember Luna was there and her facing a fear and trying to call a stick.
Yes, Norman, are you implying that an episode featuring Luna is kind of not bad?
Oh no, I'm just saying that the episode was awesome. Scootaloo was not bad.
Take aim and fire!
Oh! It hurts.
Shot through the heart!
And Norman's to blame. You gave Luna a bad name. Bad name.
Well, anywho, carrying on. Let's see. Yeah, the episode was fun. Like, there's a lot of awesome things in this one. I can't say much. And yeah, with that, I'm going to wrap it up. So, Silver, what are you going to do for next week?
Well, it's time to change gears just a little bit. We're going to shift over to the comics to talk about Friendship is Magic number 63 and the sugar abolition in Ponyville.
That is an interesting episode.
Grab your hatchets.
I'll try my best not to call a comic an episode.
Same here.
Technically, it's an issue is an episode of the comics.
True. But anyway, so yeah, next week we'll be doing the comic review, and yeah, we'll see where we go. It should be a lot of fun. It's been a while since we really did the comics. So anywho, if you have any questions, concerns, or suggestions for the show, you can contact us at thembshow@gmail.com. You can also reach us on the Twitters. The show's Twitter account is @MBSShow. And my personal Twitter account is @NormanSanzo. And Silver, where can the good people find you?
Well, you can find me on the Twitters, MLP-Silver-Quill. You can find me on DeviantArt under the same name. On YouTube, just do a search for Silver Quill or After the Fact, and you shall find me. And every Wednesday, I will be reviewing or posting an editorial of the comics on Equestria Daily.
Nice. Seppy, where can the good people find you?
You can find me doing art or other stuff on Twitter, DeviantArt, and you could also pay me $3 for a coffee. Just look up Anime Christie. You'll find me pretty easily.
Awesome, awesome. And Tara?
Well, they can find me on Facebook, DeviantArt, Twitter, YouTube, or Patreon under the name Torterra1324.
Alrighty then. And also, please subscribe and rate us on iTunes, YouTube, and don't forget to press the bell icon to stay up to date. And Stitcher Radio, and also like our Facebook page. You can also catch us on ponylive.com. If you would like to support the show, you can do so at patreon.com/TheMBSShow. With every support, you'll get a week's early access to review and discussion podcasts, exclusive and deleted content. And a huge thank you from me. Talking about the thank yous, I would like to thank Amy, Lucky Knight, Tristan, Starstream, Jeffrey, and also myself, Black. Thank you so much, guys. You're great. So, anyway, I have been Norman Sanzo.
I am Silver-Quill.
I am a Sappy.
I am a Torterra1324.
And we'll guys catch you next week with another fun episode. Yes, show. See ya.
Go forth, my drones.
Bye-bye.
Keep your drones away from me.
Never.
Oh, look, there's a drone.
Get it!